7 forward out of Waterbury, Connecticut. All four of those Raiders returners, along with Andres Feliz, freshman guard out of Dominican Republic.
I think he pronounces that Feliz.
Feliz, Feliz. Again, we're getting those, getting the rust off, WD-40 rust game. Coach, you've seen these Raiders a lot since probably before legally they assembled the team. What, tell us about them.
Well, they're very obviously very guard-oriented. Two post players. Most games are a little undersized, based on, but they play awfully hard. We shoot the ball awfully well. We're better offensively than we are defensively at this point, although we have spots where they do play really well defensively. I think the big concern with Coach DeMayo is consistency. I think now that we've got games that are more playing with a little more urgency, I think that'll pick the defense up a little bit.
Yeah. Well, this should be a good one. It's the beginning of Panhandle play for us. Pensacola State 0-1 to start Panhandle play. You don't want to start this thing off 0-2, but we're going to be pulling for the good guys in white, not Pensacola.
Well, I think the biggest thing about Panhandle is playing everybody three times. You have early chances to right the ship, but you don't want to put yourself in a hole where you can't right it. And you don't want to put yourself in a position where you have to depend on somebody else
to do your work for you, right?
Right.
Yeah.
And we just got to take care of business. They're getting ready to introduce the new president.
Yep, we don't have a new president every game. We got a new president this year. Presenting the game ball. Dr. Devin Stevenson at his first Raider game and getting a nice standing O from the folks in the crowd. Nicely done. Malik Petway at 6'7" will jump it up against Kenny Cole, 6'8" out of Baltimore, Maryland. And the Raiders control it, Jerome Rodriguez. Get up to Andres Feliz as the Raiders will attack the basket right off the bat. In and out, rebound, Kenny Coles. Coach Pete Pena, known for a lot of passing.
You know, a lot of ball screens. They'll be very patient.
There's your high ball screen by Coles. Inside, blocked by Jerome. Spin move inside off the glass. No good by Feliz. Rebound by Harrison Curry. As Woodrow will bring it up right in front of us. There's your high ball screen. Raiders double off of it and set back up defensively. 8 to shoot. Off the glass, no good. Rebound Malik Petway. It's kind of a first for the Raiders in the last few years, at least as far as I've seen, where you've got four starters back in the starting lineup, four returners back in the starting lineup. Wilson Frame for three. Count it.
Wilson Frame and commit to Pittsburgh.
That's big for him and big for Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
Big both ways.
Well, anywhere you play in the ACC is tough.
Splits the defenders. Off and knocked out of bounds. Last touch by the Raiders. Thank you. up and good as we're working on 2 minutes gone. Score is 3-2 Raiders. One bucket each. The difference is that Wilson frame three. Darrell Edwards for three off the mark.
He's generally more. When he misses, it's not that bad.
Raiders double teaming off the switch. Inside. And it finally goes for Canny Coles. That's probably his third shot, first one to go. 4-3. Pirates on top. A lot of history in this conference, a lot of history in this rivalry, too. Nice reverse layup by Wilson Frame. Jared with all 5 points for the Raiders so far. Your count with 3 minutes gone here early on. The difference in this game and the first one, no fouls so far. Kick out, 3-point attempt. Good by Harrison Curry. Coach DeMeo says, time to take off the coat and time to take a timeout. Talk this thing over. Puts his hands up, says, what's going on? There's that three by Wilson Frame on the instant replay. Yeah, Pitt's getting a good one with him.
He's going to have to play at the next level. I think he's going to have to improve his. He has ability to be a decent defender, but he doesn't play every possession with the degree of concentration that you have to have at that level.
At that level, right, yeah. Raiders with a quick little regroup after the 30-second timeout. And if you're just joining us, the Lady Raiders got their first win in Panhandle play, 71-67 earlier tonight. Minton would like to make it a sweep. Jumper good by Malik Petway.
I'm not sure that's what he wanted to run after that timeout, but
no,
we'll take it.
Yeah. One of my favorites, like you said in the last few seconds, you said one shot, and he throws up a shot, and he said, that's the one shot I took.
Yeah.
He said, take one shot, coach. I took one. Here we go the other way. Belize. Over to Wilson Frame, off the glass, and he gets the roll. Jared Wilson Frame with 7 of our 9 points now. Coach P. Pena says, what's up? 30-second timeout, Pensacola State. Time to talk about our player profile of the game. Jerome Rodriguez, who's turned really from a junkyard dog mentality into an offensive player. Sophomore forward, averaging 14.6 a game, 9.3 boards a game. If he were an Olympic athlete, he'd want to compete in baseball. If he won the lottery, same as earlier, he'd want to get his mom a house. If he could go anywhere in the world, where would he like to go? To Dubai. What's on his bucket list? A good one. Graduate from college. His dream job is to play pro somewhere and get a job as a bank accountant. Jerome Rodriguez, our player profile
He's
of the
really
game.
A class kid. Yes or no, sir. Just very polite and non-assuming. Plays hard, got a great motor.
From Santiago, Dominican Republic. Romy, so Pensacola State out of the timeout. Jumper off the mark. That was Harrison Curry. Feliz over to Wilson Frame for three. Did not get the bounce. It looked like it was going to get the second hop from here. 9-7, it continues. 2-point game. Travel call.
Good defense that time.
Four and a half gone here in the opening half. Tom Bursell, Ray Ross, got a Hall of Famer substituting admirably for Coach John Lavin on the color. Right side, Edwards thinks about it. tried to force it, it's going to be possession Raiders on the baseline. 15 to shoot.
Trying to dribble a little too much.
Belize will inbound it. Safe play into Jerome back to Feliz. We'll set it up with 11 seconds. Rodriguez, they force the double. Feliz for three, got it. That's when the good shot is the long shot. It opened up nicely, 12-7.
I've always said a good shot is when it goes in.
Yeah. .44 to play, opening half. Raiders on top by five. Baseline move. That was stopped in its tracks, but nice adjustment by Harrison Curry. He wanted to slam dunk and saw he wasn't going to get it, and he put on the brakes in the air. Wilson Frain. Won't go. It's amazing, Coach, how much faster a game will go when there's not as many, no fouls called. We had zero fouls. I know I'm going to jinx it. It's right at us, and nice hand. Raiders possession. Jerome will inbound it right in front of us. Six minutes gone. Opening half. Raiders up three. Wilson Frame is put on a clinic. Edwards joins in with a three. Pete Pena not happy with that defensive effort. Put it. High ball screen. Back over. Curry for three. In and out. Rebound Feliz. Oh, I'm going to say carry. You call that every possession in the NBA. All right, waiting on this, on the sub. Here we go. Gerald Williams out of Brooklyn, New York will inbound it.
We've gone small a little bit.
E.J. Bruce guarding Williams. Up and foul. First foul of the game by Bruce. Dwayne Woodrow. 5'10" guard out of Pensacola, Florida. High school not listed.
I don't know what high school it came out of.
We'll go to the line. Can't get the first one to fall. Or the second. Wilson Frame gets credit for the board. Inside to Jerome. 8-foot jumper, nails it. Leads up to 8 for the Raiders. Corner, Woodrow going to dribble it up top, 4 to shoot. Now he'll take the long 3 and got fouled.
Fouled, 3 shots. Bailed him out.
So Jerome will get 3 shots when we return. Oh, here we go. Coach Pena will bring everybody back.
three straight he's missed.
Yeah. Coming up empty. Woodrow again. One for four. And one more because of the shot on the three. PJ Bruce. Bringing it up, fakes the Edwards over to Wilson frame. Edwards surveys it from up top, a little hop step to Bogan. Wilson frame. Oh, they're going to call Jared for the charge, and he can't see it. I really couldn't either.
Andrew Gordon coming in, 6'10", from St. Pete. Freshman.
Dunedin High School in St. Pete. He's the only Raider whose second number in that height is double digits, 6'10". Frame, Wilson Frame out on the edge, draws two defenders. Three attempt. Fall. Wilson Frame will get the rebound. Forces it up. We'll go to the line to shoot two. First foul of the night for Pensacola.
You know, I haven't.
You haven't had the need. Timeout. I'm not sure if this is media time, but it looks like a 1 minute break. We'll take one as well. 6-point lead for the good guys. We'll be back after these words. You're watching Raider basketball on Emerald Coast TV. The timeout. You know the words of those songs? I want to put on my boogie shoes. Because how old I am. Wilson Frame at the line to shoot two. 6'5 sophomore out of Notre Dame Prep in Hartford, Connecticut. Going to go, like I said, back home up to the Northeast. University of Pittsburgh.
You know, he made actually one visit to Pittsburgh, committed, didn't take any other visits.
Richie Grant, who played at Choctachy High School, his uncle Terry Grant was all SEC running back for Alabama. He told him that. He goes, when you find your school, you find your heart, commit and don't look back, you know. Yep. Take a little rest. Ron Freeman will come in for the Raiders.
Freeman, the transfer from Kansas State, from California. Bruce is a transfer from Oregon State. He's from also from California.
Coach DeMeo has a way of finding him, doesn't he?
He has a lot of contacts.
Yeah. Off the glass, rebound, back and in. One of my good friends who's the head coach at Northwestern State, Mike McConathy, told me that Coach DeMeo is known as a relentless recruiter. If he sees you and wants you, he's not going to give up on you. Hop step and nice P.J. Bruce splits defenders. .45 to play, opening half. Raiders up 7. Missed by Pensacola State. Raiders could get it up to 9 or 10 here.
Not launch pass.
But not like that. Cross court pass picked off. Made it look easy by Darrell Lewis. Defenders split and foul. TJ Bogan will go to the line.
We're not having any patience on offense.
TJ Bogan out of Jennings High School in Jennings, Missouri. One of the returners from last year's team. 6'5" sophomore. Jerome Rodriguez coming in for TJ Bogan. I was going to say, we're going to go with 6. If they didn't see it, we were going to try it. 10-10 to play, opening half. Tom Brussell, Ray Ross with you.
Picking up man full court here, getting a little energy on the defensive end.
Williams with 10 to shoot. There's your high ball screen. Going inside for it off the glass. Nice move. Williams out of Brooklyn, New York. Happy with that one.
He should have taken a charge on that. He put his head down. Just going off tackle.
Yeah. Jumper right side by Gordon. Rebound Curry. And stepped on the boundary. Side out Raiders right in front of us. At the media table annex across the way from the standard media table. And it's going to come back the other way with a foul on the Pirates. First foul, fourth team foul. On Andrew Gordon. Pete Pena out there, he was almost in the paint. High ball screen by Coles. They'll work it back around Curry. Now Curry will set the screen for Williams. 10 to shoot. Left-hander swatted away. We've got a break 3-on-2. Jerome will lead it. And it was taken away.
He's got to give it up to Summer Guard and run the floor. He can't be doing that.
Yeah. 8:39 to play opening half, 5-point lead. Raiders got it so close to double digits, but it hasn't been there yet. Going baseline, nice assist, nice under the underhand pass, and good. And Gerald Williams, full timeout. We'll take timeout as well. We'll be back in 1 minute. 3-point game for the Raiders. You're watching Raider basketball on Emerald Coast TV. Watching from Pensacola and got to see that. That was a Niceville High School pep band, right? Coming from Niceville High School. Come over here. They do that for every home game. Feed them some pizza and they love it. Great college environment when you have that. 3-point game, 8 minutes to play, opening half. Jumper falls for Malik Petway. So starters back in for the Raiders.
Raiders zoning, yeah.
And stolen away by Petway. Edwards gives it up to Feliz. Feliz will split the defenders to Edwards on a little runner, and he got it. Got knocked to the ground. Fourth team foul for the Pirates. .729 to play here, first half.
I was hearing your breathing.
Okay.
First home game of the Panhandle Conference schedule. We'll be back here in a week. When Chipola comes in, Petway off the inbounds pass, 7-point game. Baseline move, underhand pass off, no good. Rebound, Jerome Rodriguez. Here come the Raiders, Edwards. Wilson frame, top of the key. He'll lob it inside. Scrum for the loose ball. And it's going to go to Pensacola. Actually, no timeout, Raiders. Raiders got a timeout from the bench, 30-second timeout.
I think next possession goes to us, doesn't it?
Possession arrow going that way. We'll see, I believe. Well, I'm not sure. 30-second timeout, Raiders. 6:49 to play here in the opening half. Rather low-scoring start.
Well, I think both teams are forced to play a little half-court. Defense is an issue. I think both teams are playing pretty decent defense. But I think the main thing we're not getting any transition baskets. Nor are
not
they.
Not one that I can think of.
Yeah,
you know, nor are they.
Not either.
Right. the schedule this year, the home schedule for the Raiders. We mentioned Raider Club earlier. Next week, this time next week, Chipola comes to town. Then we're off until the 1st of February, Gulf Coast State, and then a Saturday night contest against Tallahassee Community College. And then we're home against Pensacola again on the 15th and Chipola on the 22nd. And quick foul.
I think he dribbled out of bounds.
He did dribble out of bounds. Yep, no calls. So no one to the scorer's table, so that's exactly the call. 7-point game, Raiders on top. Half-court pressure, three-quarter court pressure. Left side, Edwards. Raiders, I think, a little bit of confusion to Pensacola State in this zone. Two to shoot. Blocked by the Raiders. Jerome Rodriguez with it. We're going to run the floor. Jerome. Inside. Got it to go. Assist by Feliz. The body control by Jerome. Watch him here on the replay.
Makes this. We get to double figures.
And he does. Locks those knees rather quick when he shoots a free throw. 10-point game. A steal by the Raiders. We do have it. Here we go, left side. Reverse goes by Malik Pedway. You just mentioned no transition buckets, and there we go. Couple. Timeout, Pensacola State. 30-second timeout. I think the zone defense adds to a little bit of that.
Well, I think that and the press has hurt them a little bit. They've hadn't attacked it with the intention of scoring. They've kind of gotten very passive as far as Pensacola. I think the other thing is that when we're getting the ball, we're in attack mode, and it makes a difference.
Yeah. Again, Chipola next Wednesday night. You want to see rivals, Northwest Florida and Chipola certainly are that.
All good teams are spurt teams. You know, they just,
get on runs.
Well, they get on runs, and you're playing at a pretty high level, and you relax a little bit, and they're able to get two or three baskets on you, and then they put you in a catch-up mode.
Just under 6 minutes to play here in the opening half. Opening half of the opening game of the 2017 Panhandle Conference grind. Raiders with a quick double. Pirates weren't expecting it, and they got the turnover they wanted. Up and in by Feliz. As soon as the ball crossed half court,
they attacked.
Yep. It was Feliz and Bruce on the attack. Left side, Woodrow. 13-point Raider lead. Almost lost by the Pirates. 7 to shoot. Woodrow to Curry. Curry's going to launch this one off balance. Missed everything except the backboard. Here come the Raiders in transition. The Jerome couldn't get it to fall.
Should have gone to the basket instead of away from it.
Inside. Nice move by Kenny Coles. 33-21. 12 points. 4.5 to play. Went in for the right. That was swatted away from the layup attempt. .429 to play.
It's a timeout. I don't know if it's a full or 30.
We're going to see.
I think it's a full.
Full timeout. We'll take a minute to pause for the cause as well. Raiders are up. 4.5 to play in the opening half. You're watching Raider basketball on Emerald Coast TV. Seemed like it took forever for the Raiders to get it over 10 points. The margin, that is, and now we're at as high as 13. Looks like Edwards had the shot, but he bobbled the pass. Feliz with it. 10 to shoot. Missed by Edwards. Pirates the other way. In and out for Mayo. Jerome will work it inside out. Bruce thought about it and tried the bounce pass assist. It didn't. It was intercepted by Harrison Curry. 3:44 to play.
Yeah, opening two teams with nothing to do.
Yep. Allen back over to Curry with 6 to shoot. Miss. Nice rebound by Petway. Here comes the Raiders.
He's done a great job on the glass today.
Darrell Edwards got out of jail on that one. He got caught in the air. Jumper, 12-footer baseline, won't go. 3 minutes to play, opening half. And a foul on the shot. Malik Petway again. Coach Pete Pena will pull everyone out but the shooter. Cameron Allen, 6'1" out of Greenville, South Carolina. Freshman guard.
We got Wilson Frame back in the lineup as well as Ron Freeman.
Second free throw is good. And we're under 3 to play. 10-point game. Three is good by Freeman.
He's a very streaky shooter, but when he's hitting, he's really good.
You said he's a 6'6" guard forward out of Kansas, from Kansas State, right?
Yeah, from California.
Yep. Runner goes for Dang Mayo from Brisbane, Australia. And Bruce lost the handle on that.
Tried
2 minutes to play.
Too much in the crowd.
Lost out of bounds. Last touch by Bruce. ...36-25 Raiders. We saw this in the women's game where we were up, and then all of a sudden the margin was closed. It can't happen. Left side, three, wouldn't go. Here come the Pirates the other way, a 1-on-4. And how did that go? I'm not sure that we didn't tip that in. Gerald Williams, let's watch the replay.
He's giving him two shots.
They're going to talk this one over. So the ball did go in. Count it in one shot. Darrell Lewis will come in for the shooter. Should he make? Under 2 minutes. Feliz Dodromi.
Yep.
Short. Kind of got caught in the air a little bit. Possession to Pensacola State. Raiders will pick up full court. Baseline jumper, good for Curry. Mid 12, a 13 point lead down to 7.
Spots.
Yeah.
Nobody's in the bonus.
Nope. We'll play through it. Fouls on Kenny Coles, his first. For the Pirates, minute 8 to play. The Raider Rhythms will be going at halftime. The dance team, jumper from the corner, won't fall. Rebound by Dang Mayo. And we're under 60 seconds to play, opening half. Cameron Allen. Thought about it, thought better of it, gives it up to Williams. Gets the high ball screen. In the corner, jumper, Lewis, and it falls, three-pointer. 4-point game. Pensacola State's been hanging around. They shot their way back into this 4-point game. 26 on the game clock, 12 on the shot clock. From the corner, won't fall. Good rebound underneath to Jerome. And Freeman put it up and he'll get fouled on the shot. Coach Payne is not very happy with that. Harrison Curry called for the foul for the Pirates, his first foul of the night.
Should be 7 fouls.
Freeman makes the first. And makes them both. Six points, your margin.
They're going to play it down to one shot.
Allen goes up, swatted away. Put back is good by Curry. Long launcher by Wilson. Frame was close, but no cigar. 4-point game at halftime, 38-34. We'll be back After halftime, you're listening or watching Raider basketball on Emerald Coast TV.
Inside, and it finally goes for Kansas Conference. A lot of history in this rivalry, too. Nice for first layup by Wilson.
Well, back after halftime, the Raiders would like to finish this thing off the way they would like your first game at home to be, and it would be disastrous for the Pirates to start 0-2.
Yeah, but it would be disastrous for us to lose this game.
Yeah.
Just got to start playing with more consistency.
Raiders with the first possession of the second half. Any jump ball from this point will go to the Pirates. Edwards. Starting five back in for the Raiders. And that one stolen by Darrell Lewis for the Pirates. And Joshua Lewis tried to lay it up, and that was all she wrote. Jerome came back and did a LeBron on him. Inside to Jerome, and he finishes off on the other end.
Great play.
Lead back to six for the good guys in white. Start second half. Woodrow splits defenders, takes a 15-foot jumper, no good. Rebound, Petway. Petway will take the three. Just a bit short, tried to get his own rebound, knocked out of bounds, should be, and it is, to the Pirates. You can tell Malik Petway spent a little time in the weight room,
yeah? Yeah, but he needs to spend more time shooting threes.
Yeah. lead remains at six. A minute 15 gone here in the second. Harrison Curry was on the floor. That one stolen by Wilson Freeman. I'm not sure much it was stolen, but it was just passed to him. And Jared goes down hard. Two bodies go down. Shoot. Dwayne Woodrow went down with Jared. Wilson Frame, as you mentioned earlier, heading to Pittsburgh after this season. Originally from Hartford, Connecticut. Good by JWF. And the lead is eight. The Raiders back in the zone that they ended the first half in. Rebound Petway over to Feliz. He misses the jumper. Petway will return it. Knocks it down. And just in a couple possessions, it's a double-digit lead again for the Raiders.
They keep standing out of bounds when he caught the ball.
Yeah.
Pensacola come back to man.
Ten to shoot. Normally not a problem for Wilson Frame. They'll double him and he lost it out of bounds right in front of us.
He was looking to pass and lost control of it. Thank you.
jumper for Allen. Rims out. And Raiders, two of us go for it, and then we lose it out of bounds. Unforced error big time. Inside reverse layup by Gerald Williams.
It's a good player from Brooklyn, just a freshman.
Makes an 8-point game. Wilson Frame knocks down the three, but they're going to wave it off. Offensive foul. Called on Andres Feliz.
Lost start is coming to a jump stop.
Coach DeMayo says it's time for the coach to come off again. Normally, when you and I used to do radio, it was, I think the over-under was 90 seconds on when the coach would come off for Steve Forbes. Jumper no good. Wilson Frame with the rebound, and he's going to take it down himself. Baseline move. First slam dunk of the night by Darrell Edwards. Leads back to 10 for the Raiders. With a stop here, and we get one, this could be up to 12. Nope, not to be. Scoop pass underneath. Jumper for Allen. Won't go. Rebound, Jerome Rodriguez. Lead still at 10. Just under 5 minutes gone here in the second half. Tetway. Rise, running hook, won't go. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
I think the big thing is that we need to be more consistent on offense by not being too quick to shoot.
Pedway, 6'7" freshman.
Sophomore,
excuse me, at a Waterbury High School, a Sacred Heart High School, Waterbury, Connecticut. Part of that team last year.
And, you know, his high school coach has been down several times to see him play all the way from Connecticut.
Rattles the second one in. Leads up to 11 points. Side Lewis, back to the other Lewis. Mayo down in the corner to Curry. On the block. Underneath, Kenny Coles got caught up. Here come the Raiders in transition. Nicely done. Andres Feliz.
Yeah. Oh, that's a block. Thought he had position.
They're going to call the blocking foul, yeah. Cameron Allen out of Greenville, South Carolina at the line to shoot two. 6'1", 180. Freshman guard. Makes the first. Wilson frame. Raiders running a little weave. Belize kicks it out. That way, and he got fouled shooting the three or a two. We'll see.
He doesn't need to be shooting in the corner.
Okay, they're going to say it was prior to the shot, it appears. So the Raiders will have a possession on the baseline.
Need a couple quick scores here.
Belize will inbound it. Nice spin move on the block by Malik Petway. And an unforced error by the Pirates. We'll give it back to the Raiders. 13-point margin right now. Edwards got fouled in the act. Fouls on Darryl Lewis, so Darryl Edwards will be at the line. He's averaging 13.3 a game.
Averaging, he's one of those that's capable of scoring in the 20s per game. He just has kind of lost his confidence.
Shooting 75% from the line for the year. Makes a vote.
He's got to maintain the lead.
And back to the Raiders.
Making our defense look pretty good.
Yeah. The first round in Panhandle Conference play is really kind of seeing what the others have. By the second, you have an idea. By the third time, you pretty much know everybody what they're going to, what the tendencies are, because you can't reinvent yourself in the middle of the season.
Yeah.
Wilson frame short on the three-pointer. He's 13:34 to play.
He's got to keep taking those, though, because he's one of those that has proven he can make them.
Runner. And charging. You can see the position was there.
I was concerned that he was out of the circle. I guess he was
close enough, I guess. Team 10 to play in regulation. Jumper by Feliz, and it's good.
He's going to be really good next year.
Timeout, Coach Pete Pena in Pensacola State. He's still talking about the charge. Full timeout. We'll take 60 seconds to pause as well. 54-38 Raiders. You're watching Raider Basketball on Emerald Coast TV. Back at the arena, 13:02 to play. Pirates coach Pete Payne is still a little sore about that charging call. A little change here. Raiders going to pick up full court. Feliz will be guarding Cameron Allen. Sets a pick with the official and gets it across. In that man-to-man defense. Baseline, I think he stepped out. He did. Feliz walks it up deliberately. He takes a runner, misses rim, hits backboard, rebound. Jerome Rodriguez.
At 7 on the clock.
Long three attempt. In and out. Jerome went over the back. They're going to get called for over the back. That was close.
Yep.
Jerome's second, third Raider team foul of this half. And with an exclamation point by Harrison Kirby. Curry split the defenders and threw it down, as Bill Walton would say. Throw it down, big man. Wilson Frame gets caught up, gets it to Jerome inside, and here's one back at you. Petway with the slam dunk. Jumper for three, good by Curry, and now another timeout by Coach Pete Pena. He doesn't want to wait till media time. He wants to take it now. 60-second timeout. We'll be back in 1 minute. You're watching Raider Basketball on Emerald Coast TV. two dribbles. They're going to say double dribble. Coach DeMayo.
He never stopped his dribble, did he?
I don't think he did. I think he's saying that, the official saying that he did it, he touched the ball in the air with both hands, but I don't think so. Media timeout, finally. We got another one. We'll keep it here. Again, next week, the 18th, Chipola's College comes to town. It was easy when all these were JCs, yeah. Chipola Junior College, yeah. Pensacola Junior College, but now it's a little bit of everything. Then TCC.
There's still Community College.
Community College. Pensacola is a state college along Gulf Coast State and Northwest Florida State, which rounds out the Panhandle Conference. The only one missing from back in the day, your day, North Florida.
Yeah.
Madison, right?
I think they've gone hiding. They don't have anything anymore.
Put the locks on the gym and close the school, huh? Raiders shooting 51% for the game, 26% from three-point line, 77% at the line. Shooting percentage quite different for the Pirates, shooting 40%.
Pensacola got Gerald Williams with 10 points and Curry with 16, so of their 43 points, so those two have 26 of them. They're the ones that carry in the water.
And likewise with the Raiders, Pedway and Wilson
Jared.
Frame with 25 of the 56. A total of 20 fouls between the teams. Less than half of what we had the first game. .10:45 to play here. Raiders trying to hold on, get that first Panhandle win of the year. Basket's good by number 20, Harrison Curry. Feliz on the foul. Raiders 14-2 overall. First loss was never happens hardly at home. San Jacinto came in.
Yeah, obviously we were 16 up midway in the second half.
A very good team, and then lost to Eastern Florida State College. You said that's a kind of a different one. It's a trap game right before a holiday break. Bogan, DJ. One-handed pass over to Curry. As we're at the 10-minute mark, bounce pass off a foot. It'll be possession of the Pirates with 13 seconds on the shot clock.
They need to hedge on the zone, kind of favor where Curry is.
And now Coach Mayo's kind of seen enough. He says he wants a timeout. Full timeout. We'll pause to refresh and get ready for this second half stretch of the second half. 58-46, good guys. We'll be back in 1 minute. You're watching Raider Basketball on Emerald Coast TV. 58-46, Raiders on top. Cameron Allen dribbles it up top. He'll take the long three and nails it.
This is where we got to keep them from having a run.
They get three back real quick like that. Bentway answers.
Could have been a one and one.
Could have been. Pull up jumper, top of the key, and a foul with it.
Two or three.
Shooting two. TJ Bogan called for the foul.
This plays in their favor when we put them on the line. They get the score without the clock running.
Again, Coach Pena pulls the remaining four back. Substitution. Now Darryl Lewis will come in for Mayo. He's giving up 6 inches, but gaining a lot of speed. Nine-11 to play, 10-point game. Assistant coach over there, Justin Wright, marking some instructions, and Wilson Frame knocks it down. Justin Wright, former star at Pace High School. You and I called a few of those games.
Yeah, Pace went up to a period there where they were pretty good.
Mm-hmm. Leads 12. Wilson Frame will try to make it 13. And he does. Williams, a little more deliberate over to Allen. Eight to shoot. Blocked. Follow-up three and foul. Shooting the three is Harrison Curry. Like you say, getting points back without burning time, this is the way to do it. Perspiration clean up before we advance.
Call it resting.
Yeah.
I'm doing a little playing around here. We've played 16 games, and 11 of the 16 we were over 90. No, you know, six over 90 and five over 100.
Mm.
So this is really kind of
out of our league here.
Right, slower than they want to play. But giving Pensacola credit, they've handled the tempo. We haven't.
Yeah.
They've dictated it.
Like you said, when you play Coach Pete Pena's team, it's going to be very deliberate. A lot of ball screens, a lot of passing. A lot of clock run. So it's back to 10 points. Jumper in the corner, gets the roll. TJ Bogan. So three free throws on one end, and we take it the easy way the other and bury one. Jump hook won't go. Rebound Petway. Here come the Raiders, forcing a little tempo. Oh, we're going to say he walked, and he was leaning. Pressure defense now for the Raiders.
Trying to slow it down a little bit, although Pensacola slows it down on their own.
Yeah. Seven and a half on the game clock. Nice rebound, Feliz. Here we go the other way, Feliz. Jumper out of the corner, won't go for TJ. Rebound, Williams. One dribble, Williams picks it up. To Lewis at the 7 minute mark. 10 to shoot. Runner, good. Leads 11, 66-55. Jumper for three, won't go. Other than Petway go down. He's up quick. At the 6.5 minute mark. And bounces off the glass, but that wasn't the intent. The intent was to get a foul, and he did just that. Foul's going to be on Malik Petway, his third.
They get this in single digits with 6 minutes to go. They're right back in the game. But we've got to work on getting the ball more inside. We've settled to too many jump shots.
Free throw a little long and left for Gerald Williams. He did what he wanted. He got to the line, but he came up empty that time. Again, there will be no offensive rebound on a miss because there's nobody there. Second one's made.
Unless it's a brick and it really bounces out.
Yeah, look. Coach Payne yelling for his men to come up with a stop. And they do, or do they? Yes, they do. Oh, blocked from behind by Feliz, but they're going to say he got some body to or got a hand. Timeout for media break. We'll pause and refresh as well. 1 minute. 10-point game. They won't go away. We'll be back after these words.
Too many empty possessions.
You're watching Raider basketball on Emerald Coast TV. Gerald Williams misses the first, and for the first time all night, Coach Pete Pena's got some men in the paint on free throws. Man, one of two.
Cut it to nine.
Edwards. Try to alley-oop, and we alleyed, but no oop. Fouls on Will Butler, number 21. Third foul. Jerome hit the line. Again, 6'7 sophomore out of Dominican Republic. First one rattles and goes. Second one goes as well. Leads back to 11. 5:45 to play in regulation. Cameron Allen running point over to Williams. Inside, nice adjustment by Kenny Coles. Approach 5 minute mark. 9 point game. Nine to shoot. Jerome with the jump hook.
Guys knew. Talking about getting the ball back inside.
Leads back to 11 for the Raiders. 3 point attempt, long. Rebound Feliz. Here come the Raiders in transition. And a turnover. And a nice save by the Pirates. 3 point attempt off. Shot was altered by Wilson Frame coming in for the block. Darrell Edwards will walk it, slow it down. Edwards, nice putback. Think we could say that in rhythm anymore? Nice putback by Edwards. And timeout, Pensacola State. Full timeout. We will pause as well and be back in 1 minute when we have four more minutes to go. 72-59. Northwest Florida State on top. You're watching Raider basketball on Emerald Coast TV.
Last 2 minutes, the Raiders have made a 6-0 run.
And a well-needed one.
very timely. But we've done it by getting the ball inside.
Mm-hmm. Under four to play. Cameron Allen, guarded by Wilson Frame. And a miss by Williams. I think that's Coach DeMeo's mantra. If you want anyone to get it, get let Williams have it.
Yeah.
Edwards with crossover over in the corner. Feliz, and he got fouled. So Andres Feliz will have an opportunity to extend it to make it, what, an 8-0 run. First is missed.
He's generally a pretty good free throw shooter.
And missed both. Two big misses. Williams with the rebound. Here comes Cameron Allen. Pirates almost out of bounds with it. Allen. Over Curry. Nice extra pass, but a nice block by Jerome Rodriguez. Short, rebound.
That's big that play there.
Under 3 minutes to play. Each team with eight fouls. Jumper, nothing but air, and here comes Pensacola State the other way. Allen. Extra pass in the corner. Jumper for three. Won't go. Rebound underneath. Goes for Candy Coles. And timeout, Pensacola State. Full timeout again. Back in 1 minute. You're watching Raider basketball on Emerald Coast TV.
The big guy. Yeah.
To play, 2:33 to be exact, 72-61. Raiders will have it on the baseline under Pensacola State's basket and can run the baseline if needed. Action stopped as Coach Payne is talking with the official score.
He's just trying to get his kids some rest.
And they have a nice chuckle, and now they're ready to go. Because the last 2:33, they're going to have to play all out and do exactly what they're doing here, and now timeout. Raiders. full timeout again. The game still will never end.
It's 30, I think.
Yeah, I like that. You know, when we were talking earlier, when you look around this beautiful building, it surely is the diamond in North Florida in basketball. But still kind of hard to believe that just a month and a half ago or 2 months ago, you had Virginia, Providence, Memphis, and what, in playing in here.
Yeah.
It was really, really something else. Who are the teams for next year for the classic?
Maryland, TCU, New Mexico, and I think it's St. Bonaventure out of
New York. Wow.
And Florida's coming in 2 years.
That'll be big for the area.
Yeah.
A lot of Gators here, but a lot of Gators that travel, too. And up and in for Pedway. 13-point lead with 2:20 to play. Raiders back into zone defense. And rebound by Feliz, and we'll just slow it down and run some clock as we're under 2 minutes. Edwards. Guarded by Mayotte. Wilson frame. Tried to lob it underneath to Jerome, but he wasn't looking. But I think we got a foul out of it.
Yep. Minute 30. Wasn't easy.
No, it wasn't. Raiders, assuming they hold on to this lead, will move
to. Well, I think the 11-day layoff just kind of showed.
Jumper no good at the buzzer. Raiders should move to 15-2. 1-0 in the conference. As Cameron Allen knocks down the jumper. Cut the lead to 11. Edwards inside. Jerome off the glass. Nice pass.
Nice move. Nice pass, nice shot.
With a minute left to play. Leads back to 13. Now make it back to 10. A slip by Edwards. He got away with it. On the pass, Wilson frame in the right corner. And the Raiders turn it over. Just not enough time for the Pirates. Jumper no good. And the Raiders can pretty much dribble this out with a 1.5 second differential on the game clock and the shot clock. Again, the Raiders will move to 15-2. 1-0 in Panhandle Conference play. The Lady Raiders were winning earlier, 71-67, have moved to 14-2 and 1-0 in Panhandle Conference play.
Tom, I enjoyed it.
Well, we got 1.1 second left. Anything could happen. Saturday night, Raiders are on the road at Gulf Coast State College. And then we'll be back here in 1 week to host Chipola College. Ladies at 5:30. The men will follow 20 minutes after. So for Coach Ray Ross, R.J. Murdoch, and his team, this is Tom Purcell saying go Raiders and good night, everybody.
Good night.